Every time I see that, it makes me cringe. B released a statement saying, in part, quote, "It was inappropriate and inexcusable. I crossed the line, and I deeply regret it." So let's discuss it now. CNN.com opinion contributor Dino Badalas here, nationally syndicated radio host Stacey Washington, and CNN political commentator Angela Rye. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Angela, did Samantha Bee's vulgar comment just epitomize the lack of civility and polarization that we're seeing in the country right now?
Don, that is the best way you could have answered your own question. Absolutely. I think the challenge that we have right now is just yesterday, we were hearing, or the last couple of days even, we've been hearing people go back and forth about Roseanne. And, you know, there was an intense debate that I heard with Simone and another commentator where the guy is just justifying all of Roseanne Barr's actions and how, you know, she should have free speech and blah, blah, blah. But when it comes to this side, right, all of a sudden, this is the most egregious harm ever. And I'm trying to understand when truth became so subjective. I understand that we are... obviously, we have our own experiences and we can see things through different lenses. But at some point, wrong is just wrong and right is right. And I think that Samantha Bee did the right thing by apologizing for this. It was tasteless. It was very harmful. And yes, Ivanka does have a lot of persuasion powers with her father. I think that calling her out of her name and with a word that doesn't personally offend me, but definitely offends other people and was horrible. She needed to apologize. Yeah. She has a platform that's too important to do otherwise.
Yeah, and the message was lost in all of that. She had a very good point about immigration. She lost it. But Stacey, Sam Bee, she apologized. TBS is owned by CNN's parent company. They said it should never have aired. Is that enough?
No, it's not. So, first of all, I'm on the record on my radio show and all over Twitter as saying that I found Roseanne Barr's comments to be ridiculous. They were awful, disgusting, demeaning. Any comparisons between black people and monkeys, that's a no-go in my book. And I'm always at the ready, guns blazing, to shoot that kind of commentary down. Now that I've said that, if we're going to talk about the civility or lack thereof, why does Bill Maher still have a show? If just tweeting something vulgar out is the standard, then a lot of other people in Hollywood should not be on the air. They should not be on television if that's the standard. So I think, you know, ABC and the production people, the management there, they have every right to fire or not fire, do what you're going to do. But then Samantha Bee says what she said about Ivanka Trump, and it's the see you next Tuesday, yeah, Don, but it's also, hey, you know what? Put on something low-cut and racy and seduce your father like they have an incestuous relationship. That's disgusting, vile, and demeaning.
He said he would date her.
Hateful towards women. Hey, and so he said that ridiculous comment, so we justify adding on to it? Not for me. That's not okay for me. So I think what we have to do, if we really want to be honest and have our experiences validated, is admit that there's a double standard. So Roseanne lost her job. I'm not defending Roseanne. I'm asking, how does Samantha Bee still have a job?
Okay. All right. Dean, you want to?
Sure. I mean, there's a vast difference between what Samantha Bee said, which was vulgar and provocative and wrong, and a racist comment by Roseanne Barr. And Stacey criticized Roseanne, didn't use the word racist there. Donald Trump will not use the word racist to talk about her.
It was racist.
Donald Trump, that's great. Donald Trump will use the word racist. He won't use the word racist about the people in Charlottesville.
Okay.
They're very fine people. The reality is they're far different. And Roseanne Barr has a history of anti-Muslim bigotry, which I've written about. Susan Rice comparing her to an ape in the past. Roseanne Barr should have never been on ABC. I wrote about it for CNN last month, saying you're going to have problems with her from a corporate point of view, and you do. Right now, Samantha Bee's lost two sponsors. It could result in her losing her show. I hope not. She apologized. She's an important voice. And
Samantha
a time of comedy, one,
also
I'm going to be
really
one thing done.
About other
one
women
curse
in the White
from
House.
A comedian.
There's a running list.
I would love to see the outrage of Stacey and others on the right to the bigotry and racism of Donald Trump against blacks, Muslims, Latinos, mocking disabled, defending Rob Porter, who beat his wife. How about a half of that kind of anger? I would love that. I would embrace it. We bring us all together. Let's do that.
But 12 rights, 12 wrongs don't make a right.
Oh, absolutely.
14
I'm
wrongs
not saying
don't make a right.
I appreciate
absolutely.
That.
I'm not saying that.
I'm sitting here wondering when I became Donald Trump.
Hold on.
When have I ever defended
I don't think he's attacking you. I don't
Please
think he's attacking you personally. Don't take it personally,
he just,
Stacey.
He
this
called
is not,
me out personally. He just called my name, Don. He said,
I said your name.
People
I said
on the right
your
like
name.
Stacey.
I said Donald Trump.
Defending Donald Trump. And No,
but do you?
Do
you criticize him
for
his comments? Do you criticize the president?
I have thousands of hours of radio out there on the podcast where I have definitely criticized the president as well as praising him when I feel he's done something
fair.
I'm not a sycophant, but it's not fair for Dean or anyone else who calls themselves an opinion writer or reporter or anyone in the media or the Fourth Estate, where you're supposed to be reporting, not emoting, for you to equate statements made by someone else.
I've got to go.
Unless you've researched it and listened to what I've said.
Okay, we'll be right back. I'm back now with Dean, Stacey, and Angela. So here, my question is, does context matter here? And because comedians have always been vulgar. Is it different, Angela, if they're vulgar versus racist?
Yes, from my vantage point, certainly. I think right now, comedians and anyone with a platform, really, Don, has a different type of responsibility. You asked the question leading into the first segment about whether or not comedians were held to a higher standard than the president, and I think all of us are. I don't know what it is. We called him Teflon Don during the campaign, and it still applies now. No matter what he does, no matter how egregious the action, his followers, his base, it just doesn't shift. We know that his approval rating has never gone higher than 50%. It certainly stayed in the 40s. And for whatever reason, his base is very loyal. He stokes their worst fears. He pumps and prods their anger. And it's really, really worked for him. I think the frustration is all of us have this great responsibility to try to bring everybody together, to try to get rid of some of the most egregious and ugliest things of America's past. And this president doesn't do anything except for lean into them, furthering the division that we see. And I think it's unfortunate that all the rest of us have a deeper, broader responsibility, including those with platforms, to be funny.
The reason I ask that question is because you guys all know this. I am a huge proponent of free speech.
Sure.
And that means speech you don't like.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean that you have to deal with hate speech.
Right.
Are we going to get to a point where nobody can say anything and everyone's going to be in fear of losing their jobs and they can't be honest? Because I do think context matters. If Roseanne had said that something similar in a club that she was performing, would it be different? If she said it on television, if she had said it, put it in the context of her show and she did an episode about it, there would be context. But she did it on Twitter, and there was no context behind it. So do you understand what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying. Yes, it could be different, but here's the thing. Any jokes involving people involved with politics, like Donald Trump had praised Roseanne, so she became part of the hyper-partisan world where if she says something we don't like, she already has enemies built in on the left, vice versa with Samantha Bee, people on the right looking to go after liberal comedians. If Samantha Bee was not famous and just saying this in the clubs around the country and just known, we never would have known about it. Comedians are held to a higher standard the more famous you are. When you have advertisers involved, that's why Samantha Bee, I think, no matter what, felt compelled to apologize. Even on my radio show, progressives calling saying, don't apologize, Samantha, stick to your guns. The progressive base does not want her to apologize, but I think the network does.
So, Stacey, I was speaking to someone today, and we were a woman, and we were talking about that, and she made a point to me that I hadn't really thought about, that word, the See You Next Tuesday word, is personal to her. And I said, you know what, I understand that it was vulgar and it was terrible before I had that conversation with her, but also as a person of color, what Roseanne did was personal to me. So.
And to me.
So
which is why I condemned it immediately.
Okay, that's not where I'm going with this.
Yeah.
So perhaps it's a way that people can sort of understand each other, that maybe it doesn't affect you, and so you don't think that it's awful and terrible, but when it does, it's just, when it does affect you, then maybe you should be more empathetic about listening to what other people say about it. Because the president certainly seems to think that only what Samantha Bee said matters, not what Roseanne said. Go ahead, Stacey.
I can't speak for the president, Don. I have no idea what he thinks
and the people
is,
who
is
are
more
some people who are defending him,
important.
Which you're not one of, but go on.
But I do think there's a huge dichotomy here. You're talking about something that Roseanne tweeted out, as offensive as it was on Twitter, the show's on hiatus, they've wrapped the last episode, they don't come back to start taping for weeks. She's on Twitter on her personal account, she tweets out something offensive, she's gone. Samantha Bee pre-taped that program. They actually had writers write that for her. Mm-hmm. It went through the whole editorial and approval process, and was brought before a live studio audience, filmed, wrapped, edited, sent over for production, and then released.
And sent out on Twitter.
That's a huge difference. That
was premeditated.
Sent out on social
media.
So you're saying because it happened on network television, it's not as egregious? And then if we're talking about things that are offensive, see you next Tuesday, how many times has Bill Maher called Sarah Palin, see you next Tuesday, and other women on the right? I can tell you, Don, I'm really wondering, do the people on your panel care that I'm called that all the time, that I get those kind of threats?
Sure, it's horrible.
And I'm not nearly as famous as any of the people that we're talking about.
I think everyone here cares, Stacey.
Everybody's called that.
Yeah, but I know, Angela, I've seen your Twitter feed, it's rough. But I'm talking about either we care about all of it or we don't care about any of it. So when people like Joy Behar compared, hearing from God, praying to God, to mental illness, she kept her job. She was forced to apologize by the head of Disney. She didn't even apologize.
That's the whole context, everything.
Hold on, please,
because I'm out of time. But that's what I mean about we're going to get to a place where nobody can say anything. I saw that episode live with Joy Behar, and I thought it was like, it's a joke. I didn't think she was comparing Christians, but that's how it has evolved.
It's one thing to talk to God.
It's another thing to have to hear voices or God talk to you. But that is not on the same level as comparing somebody to
a Christian. It's a textbook example of myself. I'm a Christian too, Stacey. I'm on Christian radio,
and I can tell you that was offensive. Millions of people woke up that morning. Let me just tell you,
because you were mad at Dean earlier for the same thing. I actually spoke at the Potter's House last month. So before you get too far, let me just help you reel it on back.
Let her talk, Stacey. She's talked the least on the panel.
Go ahead, Angela.
I don't know. I'm sorry that you're upset today. I understand this is a frustrating topic, but I'm very frustrated too about the ways in which folks in the sunken place who look like me and you can start creating false equivalencies like what you just did, which is to say that this person saying something asinine on daytime TV is the same thing
and
you calling somebody black a monkey who's beautiful, intelligent, and was the president's right hand. Come on, sis, we gotta do better than that.
I gotta go. We'll be right back. Thank you all. We'll be right back.
I am doing better. Thanks, God.